Namaskar friends, today I am going to discuss on two interesting topics. More likely reliefs to listed companies in disclosure requirement as per LODR. This is what consultation paper is on review is suggesting. Consultation paper on review of SEBI listing obligation and disclosure requirements regulation 2015 has suggested the following recommendations. Listed companies should disclose the financial results to the exchanges within 30 minutes of the approval by their boards. At present, such a disclosure need to be made within 30 minutes from the conclusion of the board meeting. So there is a difference between now 30 minutes of approval by their boards and 30 minutes from the conclusion of the board meeting. So now they have to disclose within 30 minutes of the approval by the boards. Some lenience have been given by the LODR. Top 100,000 listed companies based on market capitalization calculated as on March 31st every year, every financial year, will formulate a dividend distribution policy which will be disclosed in their annual reports and on their websites. Currently, this is applicable for only top 500 listed companies. SEBI in consultation paper has proposed that newspaper advertisement or notice of board meeting to discuss financial results, quarterly statement of deviation or variation will no longer be required. This is very good change. This will give a lot of relief to most of the listed companies. Besides, SEBI suggested where it is not possible to use electronic mode of payment, payable at par, warrants or checks will be issued. Under the proposal, the listed company will issue quarterly report to stock exchanges on loss of share certificates or issue of duplicate share certificates. The regulator has sought comments from public till October 11 regarding the proposed amendments to LODR regulations. The final norms will be put in the place after taking into consideration view of the all stakeholders. Besides, the regulator has aligned disclosure regarding to resolution plan, restructuring of loan or borrowing from the bank's financial institution with the changes made by the Reserve Bank of India. Corporate debt restructuring scheme has been withdrawn by the FX Bank and has been replaced with the Reserve Bank of India Prudential Framework for Resolution of Stressed Assets Direction 2019. So these are all the very changes that is likely to be suggested by the recent committee, and let us see what is going to come. Next hot topic is, will the Murugappa's holding company appoint a woman director on its board? Murugappa's parent firm to decide Mrs. Valli's Arunachalam induction on September 21, 2020. Holding company of the 38,000 crore Murugappa Group, Ambadi Investments AILS, is expected to discuss Valli's Arunachalam possible induction into the board during a shareholders meeting on coming September 21st. 2020. In January, the 59-year-old Arunachalam, a technology consultant and daughter of former Murugappa patriarch late Mr. M.E. Murugappan, waged a lone battle against seven other branches of family for a position on the 8-member all male board members. So this holding company AAL is having only male board members, and only Arunachalam is fighting to enter into the board. Now AAL's notice said that the upcoming meeting, the company received a notice in writing dated August 15, 2020 from Valli Arunachalam, the shareholder belonging to the promoters, proposing herself as a candidate for being appointed as a director of the company. Accordingly, the consent of the members is out for the appointment of Valli Arunachalam as non-executive director of the company, liable to retire by rotation. None of the directors or the relatives thereof has any concern or interest, financial or otherwise, in the above resolution said in the notice. According to Arunachalam, Mrs. Arunachalam said, "I am not aware of any board meeting or have not been invited to any board meeting. As a shareholder, my family has received the notice for proposed annual general meeting of September 21, 2020. For that, the agenda contains various items and also includes my proposed appointment to the board of the company. I am glad the family seems to seeing the light day, and the board, which consists mainly the family members, male members, has placed my appointment on the AGM agenda. Given the family controls majority shareholding in the company, I would like to believe that in a foregone conclusion that I will be appointed as a director at the AGM." Murugappa's group spokesperson said the matter is a family issue and it cannot be commented upon. So let us see. Mr. Sarnagam, one of the heirs of the 119-year-old Murugappa group, claims that their family holds over 8% of the share in the holding firm. And let us see whether Mrs. Valli Arunachalam is going to be inducted in the parent company of the Murugappa's group. Let us see and wait and see. Friends, thanking you for watching this video. I think that you will be liking this video. Like this video, I request you to subscribe my channel, please. This is R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary. Thanking you once again.